Welcome back to another Tech Talk. I'm Chris Johnston. I'm the president of Sierra-Olympia Technologies, and we're going to be talking about video that we've collected with our Ventus HD6 0.6 camera. Our team went first to Portland, Oregon. There's lots of bluffs and hills in the city, and overlooking a lot of Willamette River features and rail yard features that are critical to Portland's functioning. First thing you see is a picture of the camera that is actually a pretty compact camera compared to others with equivalent field of views and instantaneous field of views. And what you're seeing here is a white hot image of, you know, the rail yard right in front of the camera. The steel rails are reflecting the sky background, and that's why they appear pretty hot, or hotter than the rest of the scene. But it's a great testament to the resolution of the image. We've flipped to black hot in this image. This is where the high intensity part of the image is black, and the colder parts of the image are white. And what I see here is, again, resolution displayed by the fine wires that you can see coursing through the image. Humans look like humans. Details of their clothing are apparent. This is probably not full zoom, and it's probably not too distant, but again, a good display of the camera's relative sensitivity. All of our cameras have video processing, and you'll see the automatic gain control click in pretty soon. As soon as the hot engine comes in, you can see the contrast dip a little bit there. What I like about this image is the testament to the very high resolution as demonstrated by the high spatial frequency of that chain link fence that you see in the center of the image. A good camera will have the ability to resolve very high spatial frequency events or high spatial frequency targets. And a chain link fence is a good example of that, and being able to resolve the individual elements of that chain link fence is what we're very proud of here. Also, all the contrast that you can see on those boxes or those wrapped bundles in the foreground is pretty impressive. This is a very complex scene. You're seeing practically everything in focus from near to far over that great distance. Just before sunset, you can still see some shadows there. That's a feature of midwave. There's still some solar content, and the solar content renders that shadow effect on the building. And again, at great distance, you can see fine detail on a fence, on a wire. This is a spectacular imagery of birds at distance flying across the scene. To see those small features and, you know, relative to the distance from the camera and the background that you see, that's a very impressive image when you see the birds and the high spatial frequencies. This is nice. You see a helicopter flying in the scene, and we're going to zoom in on those towers out there. Those towers are 6 kilometers away, which is, and maintaining that high spatial frequency to see the individual stanchion members in that tower at distance at 6 kilometers, a testament to the quality of the camera. Another example with a solar tower and seeing individual wires at 7 kilometers, individual support tension wires at 7 kilometers. That's a good imagery. The next scenes that we're going to show are scenes captured from the Oregon coast. Oregon coast, famous for its natural beauty, but at the Oregon coast, there's also the mouth of the Columbia River. The Columbia River comes into Oregon on the Oregon-Washington border, and then most of the Columbia River shipping winds up at Portland on the Willamette River, a tributary of the Columbia. What we're imaging are ships approaching the Columbia River mouth. Now, we have tools, all ships carry transponders, and we're able to locate the inbound ships just on the internet with the transponder data, and from there we can calculate the distance. And so this is an example of a large ship, a vehicle carrier, approaching the Columbia River at 60 kilometer distance. Now, that's really fascinating when you think about being able to image objects at 60 kilometers. It's quite a distance. We're cutting off part of the ship because of the curvature of the Earth. At distance, we're imaging through an atmosphere that has lots of water, some particulate in it. Now, another feature of the Hexablue is its spectral bandpass. The spectral bandpass has a CO2 and water cutoff filter so that we're transmitting efficiently through the parts of the spectral transmission window of the atmosphere that are optimized and eliminating from the scene content that which is the water absorption band and the CO2 absorption band that is ever present. And so what it does is it gives exceptionally long atmospheric penetration capabilities with minimum interference from those elements of an atmosphere, namely water and CO2, which are present in midwave bands. Of course, we have color palettes like everybody else. Fantastic ship with lots of containers. Lots of detail, fast-moving craft. Holy cow, that was fast. That's a big ship moving at high speed. Wow. Okay, lots of detail. You can see individual ripples on the water. First of all, water is low contrast. And, you know, we're seeing reflected images off the water. That's a characteristic of midwave. It adds to the contrast. But still, the detail and the resolution there is pretty astounding. The combination of the lens design and the pixel pitch and the performance of these sensors, it just all adds up to the ideal system. Another particularly important attribute of the Ventus HD6 systems is its almost limitless cooler life. There's no longer lasting cooler on the market for a midwave system than that offered in the Ventus HD6. So there you have it, some new imagery that we've collected. Thank you for watching. Thank you for spending time with me. Be sure to visit our website to review the Ventus HD6. We have lots of video on our website, lots of video on our YouTube channel. Subscribe to our YouTube channel. We're on Instagram, we have LinkedIn. Be sure to check us out there as well. Again, thanks for joining me. I'm Chris Johnston. Have a great day.